And we are on. Very good. Welcome, everyone, to DG Game Night. This is episode 19. One more, and we got the 20. Natural 20. No, I don't know what I'm talking about. We all seem to be kind of lightly snacking, and it's hotter than blazes out there. So you'll enjoy some perspiration from time to time, and maybe a little bit of wind noise in the back from all the fans going on. Tonight we have a special guest, as in he's been with us the whole time, but he is now changing the rules around. Jimmy McMichael is our Demon Master tonight. Woo! And he's prepared a special, we're going back in time to World War II tonight. Playing, we have Ben Honeycutt.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh. And according to my profiles down here, which is the only one that matters, Chris Dupenthaler is to his right.
Howdy ho.
Chris is, yeah, we'll get into his character later. John Razor is here with us.
Hello.
From sweaty Indiana.
Yeah.
And the always enjoyable Sarah Moore is with us from Chicagoland.
I just want to point out that our AC is cranked so high that I'm actually wrapped in a blanket.
Oh my gosh.
How dare now we all you.
So hard.
Hard.
Okay. So those of you who are joining us, you might be joining us from YouTube directly. If you are, you'll see a little thing at the bottom there that says be a part of the conversation. Go ahead and click that and it'll take you to the Hangout. We have a little Q&A section up here, which I'm pulling up right now. And that's for you, the audience, to be able to toss out ideas, interact a little bit. I'm going to clear those from time to time if they're not super relevant to the story. But it's a place to kind of interact with us, interact with the story a little bit, and we'll potentially even use your suggestions and put it right in as we go. There is about a 30-second delay. So from the time that we started, we've had zero viewers, and now we have two viewers. So there's a little bit of a delay. So factor that in when you make your comments and just realize it's going to take us at least 30 seconds before we see it. Well, that is about a minute and 30 seconds too long of me talking. And so I'm Jimmy McMichael has already has all of our characters' introductions worked into the story, so I'm not going to tell you what we're playing or who we're playing, but we are playing Demon Hunters, A Comedy of Terrors, www.demonhuntersrpg.com. Jimmy is holding up the book now.
Check out that beauty.
Buy that gorgeous thing. $50. You can buy it at paizo.com. And or if you just want the crappy print-on-demand version, which is completely, I think, you get the nice fancy cover, the blue, the color cover that Ben Honeycutt designed, and we may do something with that more cool later. Anyway, take it away, Jimmy.
All right. The year is 1943, and the Brotherhood of the Celestial Torch is in bad shape. The Order of the Infernal Scepter is at the height of their power, and under the guise of the Thule Society, they've been using the Nazis to gain possession of a number of powerful forbidden artifacts and relics, and the world's becoming unsafe, not just for mankind, but monsterkind as well. And you'd all heard rumors that the Brotherhood was offering amnesty to any supernat willing to join up and fight against the Order. You figured maybe it's a trap, but honestly, it's worth the risk, because you can't live in the world if the Order destroys it. So you put the word out, you're looking to sign up, and after that, things get a little blurry. And you've all just regained consciousness inside the hull of an airplane. You find yourself strapped to a row of metal chairs. You're all shackled. Most of you, anyway. One of you, a smaller member of the group, is chained inside a heavy metal box hanging from the center of the cabin, with barely enough room to move, for reasons that will become clear. And so, you all just woken up.
I look around, and what do I see in this
You see a bunch of strangers that you've never met before. And on the wall over the door of the bulkhead, there's the symbol of the Brotherhood of the Celestial Torch.
Howdy, y'all!
I'm going to try to remove my shackles. Or will them open, specifically.
Good luck with that. They've been secured. Worth knowing all of your abilities.
Okay, so this eerie, strange voice comes from the box that's hanging from the room there. That hello, everyone. Is that right?
Nope, that was okay. The box is Ben Honeycutt's character.
Oh, very good.
And we cannot see into the box.
What was that?
We cannot see into the box.
There's a tiny air holes drilled into it, but can't see too well.
From the inside of the box, I call out, "Are we on a plane? I smell a plane."
We're on a plane. You all look like nice people. Can we be friends?
No.
Can we see each other? Like,
yes.
Are we in the same? Lumber forward, and you see this massive stitched together body, and says, who are you all?
I'm Andy.
My name is Shannon.
You have no head. Where in the god?
That's important.
Where is your head?
I don't know.
Where? That is scientifically amazing.
Where are you talking from?
I don't know.
I'm sorry, what is happening out there?
Someone lost their head.
There's a person out here speaking, and he doesn't have a head.
You're made of, like, what, 5, 6 people at least? I'm surprised you're amazed by this.
Hey, I know it's brilliant, but sometimes I'm outmatched. It happens every now and again.
You both look very nice.
The door at the end of the hall bursts open. Door at the end of the hall bursts open, and a guy comes marching through in a blue jumpsuit with the Brotherhood logo sewn onto the sleeve. He's got a weathered, craggy face, sharp, severe crew cut. Name over the breast pocket says Cragmore. Says, "Good morning, Monster Squad. Hope you all had a lovely nap, because it is time to go to work. You have all volunteered to fight for the Brotherhood, and God knows we need all the help we can get."
I call out, "Holy shit, there's monsters in here?"
I didn't really.
I am not a monster! I am a feat of scientific amazingness! We actually said that back in 1942.
Technically speaking, I'm not a monster. I am a fairy.
Every last one of you monstrosities has been brought on to fight the cause. Not a lot of people are liking it. Frankly, I don't care one way or the other. You're here because the Brotherhood needs your help, and you've signed up, and that is a good thing.
So is there some kind of orientation or training thing? Is that what we're doing?
I wish to gods we had time for that sort of thing. We don't. The order is everywhere, and we are spread crazy thin. So, here's the situation. The Brotherhood recently captured an experimental Nazi war machine, something they're calling a Kugelpanzer. It runs off an exotic form of energy called Vril. This is a bad thing. Vril is a powerful form of energy so concentrated that it only exists in liquid form and is only found in the middle of the hollow earth. We've got word from a Brotherhood informant inside the Thule Society that the Krauts have drilled into Hollow Earth from a facility in the Owl Mountains for something called Project Risa. I don't know what the Order could do with an unlimited supply of Vril, and it is your job to make sure I don't find out. We've got an informant inside the facility named Felsbrecher. He'll have more information for you once you're inside. Your mission, infiltrate Project Risa facility, contact Felsbrecher, and wreck up the place.
Sounds like fun.
Yeah, I may be an urban legend, but half of that sounds made up.
I'd like to, what do I know about Vril and Hollow Earth and all that stuff? I'd like to, I don't know if I need to roll for that or if you want
me
to...
Yeah,
give me some
kind of knowledge.
Yeah, clever research and development here. And... Ooh... And I roll a 1 on one of them. But I don't have a lot of faith dice. And so I'm going to go ahead and endure that I have some brain damage.
Sounds good.
And so I'm not going to re-roll this. I'm just going to go ahead and endure this. And I'm going to subtract this die that I rolled a 1 on. And I'm just going to take the 7.
Okay.
And I have some brain damage, so details are a little fuzzy, and I might have a headache.
As far as you remember, you have heard of Vril, but you can't remember if it is a potent explosive form of energy or a delicious dessert topping.
Could be both.
And I say, it sounds tasty. I wonder if it would go good on ice cream.
Yeah, death by chocolate ice cream.
Now with new Vril.
So, just real quick, out of story question. Is the gremlin just going to be Bullock in a cage?
Yeah, listen, I'm like a fun-loving, mischievous gremlin over here.
Bullock in a fursuit. Oh, all right, so, look, I gotta be honest with you folks. This is not going to end well for you. Technically, this qualifies as an alpha-level threat, but Alpha 1, our top chapter, is otherwise indisposed with a different impending apocalypse. You are not our first choice. You are not, frankly, our 10th choice, but you are what we have left. You've been selected.
You're really filling me with confidence.
Really,
well,
nice man.
This is how much confidence I've got in this thing working out. You haven't been chosen.
Go team.
You've got skills. You're here because you're powerful and you're expendable. You will not be coming home from this to a ticker tape parade. Frankly, in all probability, you're not coming home from this. You're here for two reasons. To FUBAR the Order's plans, and to die as heroes. Any questions?
Why are we strapped to the wall?
Red light overhead starts flashing. Look, you know, I'm sure you guys will figure it out on the way. Slap a button on the wall. The floor drops out from beneath you. Your shackles release. I call out, "Welcome to the Brotherhood!" As you plummet through the earth. The static lines on your parachutes deploy.
I don't have a parachute.
Like I'm falling over here.
You don't have a parachute.
I don't have a parachute. I open my wings.
Good call.
I didn't get to answer his question.
So you look around outside. It is pitch black at night, and you're headed slowly down towards a wooded area on the outskirts of a mining facility. You touch down without event, and the lid on Pilzer's box opens up, and he springs out free from his confines.
Yeah, I spring out all joyful-like, jumping around, mischievous guy, look at me.
What in the hell is that?
Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing about you, Patches.
He looks like a very nice friend.
I am uncomfortable by you, little town man.
Wow.
So, are we going to talk about the puppet?
He's a talking puppet.
Okay.
So how did you do that? Do you have a brain?
I don't know. Maybe we should find out.
Well, I would like...
I don't like the way he's looking at us.
While you're bouncing around talking to each other, you hear somewhat nearby the sounds, the unmistakable sounds of German urination.
That's very specific.
It's unmistakable.
Clearly German. Efficient. Straight to the point.
Exactly.
You guys hear that? It sounds like a pissin' schnitzel or something.
Ah.
Fish wassail. I don't know.
There's,
good.
I don't... How are we supposed to be a team when we don't even know what who we are or what we do?
Do we want to talk to the urinating German? I can make that happen.
I'll go see if the friend.
We'll make that happen.
Make it happen?
Yeah, make it happen.
Okay, I would like to... I'd like to use my friends to sing to lure said urinating German into our midst.
Sounds good.
Great. So I'll use Fringe, and I will use Flashy, because that's a flash I'm using.
This will not
roll a 17.
That, wow. Okay. I was going to hold up and just set it 5, so you pretty much own this guy now.
Yeah, you.
So the guy's family at home's like, hey, kids, pack your bags. We're getting called somewhere.
That is a success with style. I don't know if you were thinking about an overcome roll there, Jimmy, probably.
Yeah, I was.
And so what she gets now is a boost. Yeah, temporary aspect that goes away after it's used.
So what do we want to call this guy? Let's call Schustoffer. D6 on there.
There
alright. Nice.
Alright.
Hopefully he's made himself decent before wandering into our camp. He might still be peeing. I'm not sure.
So, yeah, he had wandered out into the wooded area on his patrol, and you have just captured him, and that guy is going to tell you anything you want to know.
Wonderful. All right, fellas.
Where is the Vril?
Maybe we should ask about how to get into the facility first.
Well, the Vril is in the mine.
So we need to weigh in.
Show us the mine.
He jerks his thumb over the shoulder, pointing towards the... there's a whole facility there. There's a barbed wire fence rung around it, and patrolling back and forth out in front of it is this bizarre... Oh, why didn't I have this pulled up? Oh, yeah, I do. Spherical tank that is just zipping around back and forth. And it looks like this. Oh, hang on. Close some secret stuff. There we go. All right. So these things are zipping around back and forth at an alarming speed for an armored vehicle.
How many... Are those little tank things do you have, friend?
Just the two out front at the moment. The rest are parked in the hangar.
Yeah, and how many other strong, strapping gentlemen like yourself are in that hangar?
We have a full complement here.
Lovely.
Roughly 300.
Great. That's great. I'm excited about all of that.
Well, you should be able to just sing them right to sleep.
All of them?
I don't know.
I or love good time.
Or we could send Captain No-Head over there. Seems what are you, a reaper?
Sort of, yeah. I'm a Doulahan. I do some reaping. Reaping is part of the job. Doulahan, I'm a fairy.
You deliver babies?
No. No, just so I'm a reaper. We'll go with that.
So, do we get all the information out of this guy that we would like?
Well, I have to say, the Brotherhood dropped us off in a very convenient location. We must thank them later.
Yeah, this guy's super low level. You're not going to get much more out of him at this point.
Okay.
I have a headache.
Can I eat him?
You are free to do whatever you like with him. He's your slave.
You look yummy.
I get hungry. I haven't eaten in a while, and I'm a nervous eater. I'm going to eat him. It's just like at least an arm. I'm going to eat at least an
arm. Do you like that ground or just right off?
I prefer them rare. Just okay. Not right on the bone. Thank you guys. Anybody else want? I'll share.
I don't eat.
But this looks fun. Like, I will grab the guy and see if I can rip him apart.
Great.
It's for science. I want to see what she can do.
Well, he's not fighting back on anything, so.
Okay.
Normally, he'd fight little, back, but not with that role.
What about you, little mouthy guy? You want to eat a little bit of this?
I like eyeballs.
No, other little mouthy guy. That's terrifying.
Okay. I don't know if this is going to work here. Oh, wait, that's flashy, so I need to do flashy. Okay. Jimmy, I'm going to see if I can use my Raging Hulk stunt.
All right.
Because I'm big and scary monster, I get +2 when I flashily... Oh, I'm flashily defending against attacks. Never mind.
I can tell him to attack you.
Nah.
You
I'm
would.
Just going to forcefully try and rip him apart. So, okay. Damn it. All right. I'm burning a demon die.
Uh-oh.
That's not even better at all. That is a 7 total, and you get a demon die. Good for you.
You get about halfway through, and now he's screaming.
Oh, shit.
And you've attracted the attention of one of the Kugelpanzers.
I'm just gonna go ahead and reap this guy. We need that. We need him to be quiet. So I am going to whip him good.
Nice.
Which gives me a +1 when I attack quickly with combat and tactics. So that is a d10 and another d10. I'm so glad I have multiple sets of these. Which gives me... Oh, wow, that's not great. 6... plus my 1, so 7.
At this point, that's enough. He was already torn halfway in two, so. He's quiet, but you have drawn attention, and the tank is headed your direction.
I charge the tank.
Oh.
All right.
I'm now pissed off that I did not pull this guy apart for science. So... I am going to charge the tank and punch it.
Well, the tank has ranged attacks, and you do not. So the tank's going first in this one.
Yeah, sounds good.
So, all right. We're going to pull up the Kugelpanzer here. He's going to quickly fire off a shot at you. And a little bit of experimental Reatron cannon in there to back it up.
Okay.
And
now I am going to flashily defend as a Raging Hulk. Although that only works if this is against normals who've never seen anything supernatural before, so you'll have to decide.
You're good.
Okay. So what did you get?
I got a 14.
Damn it. I'm going to have to use some juice.
A tank.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to invoke intelligent design, but crude methods. And I'm going to go ahead and invoke, take a condition, really pissed, to deal an extra d6. Or, no, excuse me, I'm defending, not attacking. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to see how much this hits me for. Okay. That is an approach, and I rolled a 1. You get a demon die. I'm re-rolling it.
Alrighty.
That is an 8. Worth it. yeah. Max. Okay, so that's 13 plus 6 is 19.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
Well done.
Yeah.
When you go over on a defend, what happens?
Nothing.
Okay, cool. So you just don't take any damage from that.
Well, if I succeed with style,
yes.
am I over 5?
I'm 14, what'd you say, 19?
19, no, I guess I'm exactly
at
5.
5?
Yeah, so that so I would get a boost.
Okay. What do you want this to be?
How about... I don't know.
We're going to call it Broderick Smash.
That'll work. Broderick Smash. Even have, and I'm going to use the exact same stunt, Broderick Smash.
That's right, you do, don't you?
Okay. May I?
Yes, you may.
Okay. I am going to forcefully... Where's my forceful die? There it is. Use my reanimate. And I am going to take really pissed. I'm going to cash in on Frederick Smash over there. Okay, not bad. 8, 11, 16.
Nice.
Amazing.
Nice.
Okay.
For that many dice, that's actually kind of sick.
All right, I'm going to attempt to dodge this using my superior maneuverability. So I will quickly... Oh, I had that right, the person. Quickly maneuver, and I'm going to... add in Zippy Armored War Ball. 4, 7, 8, 9. That is a 10. What did you say you had?
16.
Oof. All right. However, you connect with it, and there's a glowing shimmer of energy across the hull of the tank, and mm-hmm. It does not take any damage. Because I'm armor-plated, I do not take damage from conventional weaponry, which it would include fists. You do, however, knock it back about 10 feet.
Wow. That gives me a different idea. I say, we ain't hurting these guys. Ugh. Throw them! It's time to play Donut's Ball!
Oh my gosh.
Somebody else's turn. I don't know, are we initiative or something?
Sure, why not?
Okay. Gremlin.
What up? So, I gotta sneak my ass onto that tank. Let's see here. I'm gonna use my, Sneaky D10, covert ops D6. And I got
distracted and a little spinny from him moving around, so this is not going to be a very difficult thing to do.
Yeah, I got 8.
That'll do it.
Okay, so I sneak up on, and I want to use my stunt mechanically inclined, if I can.
What is your stunt?
It says, I gain +2 when I cleverly create an advantage or overcome an obstacle by sabotaging a piece of equipment. I want to mess with that tank's gun.
I'm sure you do. However, sneaking over was your move.
Oh, shit. Okay, well, I snuck over. Who wants to go next? Okay, Puppet goes next.
Puppet.
Woohoo! I love going next. All right, well, there's no guys, like, outside of the tanks. They're all, like, inside the tanks, right?
For now.
Okay.
You better shut this thing down quick.
I think I am going to cleverly use covert ops to see if I can... is there only one that's kind of near us?
The other one is headed over. It was drawn by the discharge of the cannon.
Right. are we in the woods?
The cannons are, or the tanks are right on the edge of it, so Froderick is out, and Peltzer's riding on one of the tanks, but the rest of you are hidden in the woods still.
All right. I'm going to hide and lay in wait for this one that's coming our way.
Sounds good.
More play toys! Let's play ball!
Choose who goes next. Oh, I see.
That's a 19.
Hidden as shit.
Ew. Gone. Poof. Gone entirely.
I'm a clown. Now I'm nothing. All right. I think the siren should call him over here.
So that created a temporary boost called Where'd the Clown Go?
Yeah, I feel like we should have them all gathered in one place. So I can totally, if you're having me go next, I can try for singing them all in. Yeah. I'm also going to that's not really a physical obstacle. And I will invoke my social engineering aspect, which is maybe if I hum with you, Barnes.
All right.
Wow. I rolled 3 ones. Which is amazing.
So, mechanically, here's what's going on with those 3 ones. First of all, the faith die that you spent to invoke that aspect is not spent.
Great.
You can keep that. Now, your approaches, you may wish to re-roll those if you want to. That would provide a demon die to the DM for each one that you choose to do.
You know, it seems like I should re-roll them.
That would be good.
I'm just saying. Let's give that a whirl. Redo it. Redo the whole thing. Oh, that's so much better. That's a 14.
All right. So
much better than 3.
What was your goal?
To call the people over so that they would be accessible to all of us.
Cool. So the second tank is drawn by your siren song, and it drives over, parks itself next to the first one.
Oh, that's so interesting. Wonderful. All right, Headless, take it away.
All right. So the tank is over by, the other tank is by us now, right?
Yep.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and start hitting it with my whip and see if that can actually damage the magic shield it's got.
All right.
So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to whip it good. Hit it fast. That is a 13.
All right. Versus... I'll toss one of those in there, too. Oh, that's the wrong button. So, versus 9. So, you got me. Your magic managed to cut through a little bit. So, you have inflicted a spine-whipped condition.
Hooray.
Took out one of my mild conditions.
Because whoever gets spine-whipped...
Because that is gross.
That is completely unconventional.
All right, so two tanks up in a row because no one chose me.
It's true.
All right, so let's. I'm gonna quickly pop off a couple shots here at. Oh, let's call it Roderick. He looks like the biggest threat. Get that experimental Rheotron cannon fired up. Oh, not all of those are the right dice. So, 20.
What?
Ooh, yeah.
Ow.
Ow.
Ouch. Oh, okay.
It's just a short adventure, you guys.
Okay, I'm going to Raging Hulk defend, flashily, and my... So, that's not going to be enough. I'm going to invoke Dr. Frankenstein, and I... might need to invoke the other one shortly. Let's see here. That's 6 plus... what's the worst that could happen? I am seeing one particular flaw that I should have taken, but whatever. That's a 14 versus your 20.
Yep.
That's a 6. Yeah, fuck it. I'll take it.
All right. Let's give you a mildly irradiated condition. Actually, 6. Wouldn't that be 2?
That'd be 2.
Yeah.
All right. I'll... And glow in the dark.
Glow in the dark.
That could maybe work for our advantage. So.
Yeah.
Just makes him scarier.
All right. And the second one. Does the exact same thing.
Well, I am glowing in the dark. It's a little easier to see.
You're real easy to spot now. So, 10, 6, that one's a 19.
Damn it! Oh, Jesus. Okay. Enough of this bullshit. I am going to... forcefully defend. Oh, you know what? I didn't add my +2 on there. That's okay. Might want to do that again, though. maybe I'll do that. That's safer. At least I know I get the 2. Okay, those 2. And I'm going to invoke Igor! Fetch my repair kit! And the whole point is to avoid conditions, so I shouldn't take a condition.
Yeah.
Well, the extra rolling I felt was helpful, so that's a 9, 10, 11, plus 5 is 16, and you rolled a 19, I'm going to burn a demon die.
Alrighty.
For a 3, 19 exactly.
Perfect. So, nothing. Flies straight over your head.
But...
And,
I said, but at the same time, I now have zero faith dice.
Very true.
And it's the tank's turn again.
No, the tank went just went twice.
So. Two tanks. So now it is, let's go Gremlin.
Okay, so I'm going to use my mechanically inclined stunt. I'm going to try to just destroy the tank's capability of firing or something.
So, what is this? Are you attacking? Are you creating an advantage?
I want to create advantage.
All right.
Maybe I want to try to set it up so the next time the tank fires, it'll just blow it open and create a weak spot or something.
All righty.
We'll call it, like, tanks for the opening or something.
Thanks.
All right, so cleverly, D8. No, D10. Wait. Oh, sorry, I have two different character sheets. The new version has... the new version has sneaky D10, clever D8. So I'm going with that one. D8.
Now you don't get to switch between the two.
No. The
and now the one I'm using is the sneaky D10.
I like this version better right now.
Yeah. Yeah, there's 50 more of them. I made a joke.
To 8 viewers right now.
Nice. Okay, so I want to throw in my discipline, fly in the ointment / monkey in the wrench, the all classic right. Bruce Willis line. Add a faith die on there, and then I'm going to use my gremlin special, just my connection with machinery. I know just what to do, so I'm gonna roll my D10 fringe.
Awesome.
All right, here we go. That'll be 11.
All right. For you, since you're a gremlin, that was going to be a 5 opposition. So you've created your advantage and ooh, also discovered the trouble aspect of these Kugelpanzers, which is that they have a flimsy rear stabilizing wheel.
Man, this rear stabilizing wheel is flimsy as shit. I just discovered that.
I can't remember what you called your advantage.
Tanks for the open.
Tanks for the open.
Now, technically, that now has 2 die 6 on it.
Yes.
All right. Did all 3 of the tanks go?
And you ate that Nazi, so that one's gone.
Yeah.
Did all 3 of the tanks go? Or only 2?
Yeah.
And they both went?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I want to throw it back to the big hulking patchwork monster and see if he can take advantage of the weaknesses I've created on this tank.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you.
No, well, thank you.
Now, well, I appreciate you pointing out its weakness, and I can scientifically understand that from an engineering standpoint, I should pick it up from this wheel and smash it into the other wheel over there on the other one and see if I can knock them both out at the same time. I would do that if I had any faith dice left. So instead, I'm going to forcefully use my reanimant, because I can't justify throwing a tank with research and development, much as I want to. And I'm going to cash in, what do we got there to play with? tanks for the opening. Oh, and Froderick Smash is gone. I used that last round.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, guys. I think I'm going to take them both. That's all right.
Go right ahead.
All right. Not a one in the crowd.
Good. Like
all right, so that's 6, 10, 15. It's not enough that I want to get. I'm going to roll a demon die. 18. I'm going to stand at 18.
All right. Versus, I can't math, 13, 12?
12. Okay, you're a writer, not a mather.
So, yeah, you, what were you doing? I was picking one tank up.
I was trying to pick one tank up and throw it into the other tank.
All right, yeah, that did the trick. You grabbed it by the wheel, smashed it into the weak spot at the back of the other one, and they both burst into flames.
All right.
The gremlin's still on top of me?
Sorry. I'm going to go for the clown.
What does that mean?
The clown's going to go next.
Okay, but they're both dead.
Oh.
The tanks are gone.
Okay, got it.
Excellent. I eat their eyes.
I go home.
Yeah. I'm going to go start working for the Nazis now.
I'm out.
I am out. That is bullshit.
Are we sure this guy's on the right side?
He's a scary clown now. I hate it.
bizarrely, you don't seem to have drawn any attention. The facility off in the distance is, despite having apparently limitless amounts of this bizarre power, keeps itself nice and dimly lit, and you did all this relatively in the darkness and hidden.
Well,
that's convenient as shit. I like that.
Massively convenient. I am going to try and examine the tanks and see if I can discover the generator of said Vril thing. And I'm going to do so because I have 3 mild conditions. I'm going to endure some brain damage. And I'm not really going to learn a whole lot, I'm sure, but I need some faith dice. So so that will be my clever and my research and development. And I get a 7.
All right. Sure, you find a weakly armored tank in the back of it that seems to contain some kind of glowing yellow liquid that's seeping out into the ground and starting fires wherever it touches.
Don't touch that. Ow, my head. I guess I'm gonna it's the end of the fight now, so I guess we have, if anybody's got mild conditions, we can try and shake them off. Is that right?
Sure.
I know.
Pretty sure you're the only one who got hurt.
Yeah. No. Anybody help put me out here? I'm still glowing. I actually might need somebody else's help for that.
Looks like you play hard.
I don't know what I could do to help.
Yeah, like if you need something to fall off, I could help you out with that.
Not a lot of healers in this group.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, there's a specific action, I think it's just called a recovery action or something.
Okay.
I don't have the book in front of me, but I think it's an overcome and whatever.
I can eat your soul.
Wow.
Thanks. Well, I presume we should just keep moving. Head towards the facility.
That sounds like fun.
Let's let the clown go first.
Is the clown up for that?
Go ahead, Clowny. I bet there's lots of fun friends to play with.
I like playtime.
I know.
I get sweaty at the thought of more tanks to fuck with, and I just take off toward this facility.
So you approach the facility. You find it's ringed by a barbed wire fence. Bolts of electricity, or like little electric arcs, seem to spark along the top of it. And there's a guardhouse. There's an opening where it seems to be guarded by a single person.
He's not married or anything?
What was that?
They're not married?
Yes, exactly.
Available.
Okay, so first things first, we got to take that fence out. I'm already working on that, actually, because I got thirsty as soon as I saw it. I'm like, some tech. I got to go touch it. I got to play with it. I gotta go rub myself all over it.
Oh, God. Is he doing that? Is he rubbing himself all over the fence?
Take an observe action. We'll see what happens.
I don't know that I really want to see it.
Let's go ahead and roll that again. The clever D8.
Okay.
Fringe D10. And I am going to try to sabotage the fence.
All right.
As soon as I can find my D8. I know what that looks like. Okay. All right. So 9
we're
plus
up against
2.
A D10. Or a 10. 11.
It's, 7, 2 plus 2, 11.
All right.
And Jimmy, by the way, just for anybody who is interested, the recovery action, if it's a mild, you're trying to hit a 5. If it's a 10, or if it's a moderate, a 10, severe, 15. And it's a normal roll. Approach plus discipline.
Alrighty.
So I made those. That doesn't mean that they necessarily go away, but if you succeed, you start getting rid of the condition over time. If you succeed with style, you can clear a mild or moderate condition right now. And
right.
I did that. I did twice. So I guess I'll be not really pissed anymore and... maybe I'm still glowing, but I'm on my way out.
All right.
Sorry.
It's a dim glow.
It's smoldering.
Just left hand. It's really weird.
So Peltzer just chomps right into the electrified fence and tears a chunk out of it, breaking the circuit, and so it is now just a barbed wire fence.
Fantastic.
I smoke a cigarette in satisfaction.
So there's only one guard on the other side?
Yeah, one guard at the shack.
All right.
You should throw me in the shack.
Or I could fly over as wing.
That's good, too.
That's good, too. So I would like to take out the guard. That's what I would like to do.
Okay.
To fly over and use my combat and tactics aspect, death from above.
Well, this guy's got no idea you're coming, so let's call it an opposition 5.
Great. So, what's the one of these?
It's a Nazi. They're cannon fodder. So.
Yeah, they're jerks, is what they are. And I got a 15.
All right. So what does this look like?
So I give myself a little run up and take off and swoop up over the fence. And when I get high enough to sort of tuck in my wings and, like, dive bomb in and just break his neck.
All right.
And then land gracefully.
All right. Yeah, you not only break it, you tear his head right off.
I do.
So you've got that clutched in your talons.
I'm eating it.
And then superhero landing.
Yeah.
And so, that was success with style, so let's just call it, I've got a Nazi head.
Oh, he did not see that coming.
Nice.
So now, you are carting around the head of a Nazi for reasons. Maybe it'll come in handy. So the gate is no longer guarded.
I'm just going to gesture.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, I think she wants us to come in there.
That's a safe bet.
Brilliant!
I thought she wasn't playing Wen.
Hi.
I'm seeing you guys all in here.
Come on.
I'm a 6-inch bullock, and you're a winged Wen right now.
So we go through the fence.
Yeah, we go through the fence.
You hear kind of a large-ish gathering, kind of murmurs and stuff, and they seem excited about something. It's coming from around a couple corners.
Clown, you should spy.
I'll go play with them.
Hey, why don't we give the head to the headless one and have him walk up and say, "What's up, boys?"
True. I could do that.
Perfect.
I like that.
I drink a little bit from it first, and then I hand it over.
I'll put the head on my neck start heading toward the voice.
Literally.
Fix the face before you do.
Oh, yeah. I'll make adjustments as needed.
All right, you you round the corner and see what appears to be kind of high-ranking. There's some high-ranking Nazis in there. There's some people in what appear to be ceremonial robes. They're probably Thule Society, and they're all kind of bouncing around, excited, and talking to each other in German. Which, do you understand German? Let's say you do. Let's say
that
you were all chosen for this because you were monsters who understood German.
Well, the head does. Maybe she's connected to
it. Yeah, there you go. And they are also very excited. They're saying, he's here. He's coming.
Who's coming?
The Führer.
Shit. I'm not going to say that one out loud. Like, oh, is that today? Damn.
He's here to see off the inauguration of the big experiment.
I did not see that coming.
The experiment with the Vril?
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
It's going to be a great day for the Reich.
Yeah. Hooray! He's going to start slowly backing. Like, I have to make sure that my my station is in order. I wouldn't want to disappoint the Führer.
I have a thing. I left the oven on. I'll be right back.
Nobody notices you leave. Nobody cares.
I have to wash my cat. I'll head back to the group and be like, so Hitler's coming.
Oh.
Like now.
God damn it. I bet he wants to play, too.
Wow.
Maybe don't play with Hitler. He's not a great guy. He's coming to oversee the experiment that they're doing with the Vril.
What experiment?
I should have asked. I should have.
I have to see this. This could make advances beyond my wildest imagination.
So we should probably find the science.
All right.
Come with
so
me.
You're muted.
If we're infiltrating this base deeper, we should probably find some kind of radio communication shed or something and let me get all freaky on it. And see if we can kind of take them by surprise.
Oh. He got all freaky. And
somebody cut out his radio communication shed.
He got taken by surprise.
This is what happens when you let a gremlin touch your stuff.
So let's say he ran off to do that.
Okay. Very committed.
Awesome.
What was the guard guarding? The door?
The guard was guarding the entrance to the facility. The crowd is guarded around the mouth of the mine.
Alright, so we wanted to get in the mine, so we can't let you go through them.
Looks like the party's over there. Maybe we should join.
Sounds good.
Maybe
we'll blend in.
I don't think so.
You could wear that uniform.
That's true. There is a uniform attached to a headless body you could wear.
Me?
Who are we talking to? Me?
Anybody. Except maybe the big guy. Maybe the clown. But we can smuggle the clown in easily.
I don't think it will fit over my wings. I mean, also I'm a lady. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but not a lot of ladies in the...
What I want to do is look for any Nazi insignias on this guy's uniform.
All right.
And I want to rip them off. If there's more than one, the better. That would be great. I start ripping them off, and then I start sewing them on each of our uniforms or whatever we're wearing, our clothing. It doesn't even matter where. It's like cockeyed and little string, you know. It's just sort of slapdash. And I want to create an advantage. Yes, we are the Nazis.
Sounds good.
I'm going to do this. This is not clever. This would be quick. Social engineering? Shit.
Sure.
That's not what I want, though. Can I justify research and development?
Sounds like sewing.
I saw this once no.
You've got sewing experience from putting those bodies together.
Oh, that's true. I guess I can, use my, okay. Research and development. And...
Honestly, I'm not going to make you roll for this. This is the dumbest, easiest thing in the world.
No, I... Well, I rolled like shit anyway.
Well, you got it. No one was going to fight you on this. You ripped off the insignias, stitched them onto everyone's shoulders. The tank blew off all of your clothes, so you stitched it directly onto your arm.
Yeah. Why do I have a swastika over my nose? It's kind of uncomfortable.
So perfect that it's on your face. I love that. I love the idea that you're small enough that the swastika would be like your whole body.
So yeah, you are all the Nazis.
Okay. And
let's go play.
I say, yeah, we're here for the experiment, right?
And the Nazis are too distracted by the Führer's existence to even notice that more people have joined. Because there he is, up at the front, giving his mean Nazi salute and speech about how wonderful this is, how great it will be for the Reich, and the incredible power of the Vril.
We
Guys, let's kill him.
let's just go into the cave. Let's just go in the cave.
All right.
They're enthralled.
Is that what you're going to try?
Yeah.
All
right. I'm going to need some kind of stealth move.
All right.
From every single one of you.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Oh, wow. My covert ops is a D4. And so is my sneaky. All those would be fantastic.
I rolled next. I got a 10.
I have a 6.
I'm actually going, I think this is important, I'm actually going to burn my only faith die that I just earned, and I'm going to do this clever and covert ops with always encrypt your data. And I get a 15.
Woo!
Well, nice. Done. Andy?
10.
All right. And, hey, so Peltzer's back from damaging the radio shed.
Hey, guys.
And you are trying to sneak past Hitler.
Oh, good. Wait, no. No, stop, right there. My third stunt, Inglorious. I gain +2 when I cleverly attempt to kill Hitler.
Oh, this is not... That's not the plan.
I have been out of communication. I have no idea what's going on. Okay.
He just shows up.
Around the corner, sees Hitler, and goes for it.
I've got my little knife. I'm going to try to like stab him, but like not be seen. Because I'm like 3 inches tall. Like no one can see me. Or did I say 6? I don't remember. I'm between 3 and 6 inches tall, depending on what kind of electronics are around me and how much I want to get on them. But... that's going to be sneaky D10. My combat and tactics is only 4.
Seems bad.
Yeah. Instead, I'm going to try to sabotage his heart with a foreign object.
That will not be allowed.
Okay. I'm going to research and develop a technique for diverting blood away from the heart.
Keep trying.
I'm going to do it quietly. Can I at least use my D6 covert ops instead of my D4 combat?
Yeah, sure. All right.
That's a spy cool. thing. Yeah. Spy assassination.
I'm also going to throw on my discipline. I can hide in a coffee mug, just to really emphasize how small I am.
All right.
All right, and then I'm going to try to stab this guy in the heart. All right, here we go. 2d6s, sneaky d10. Oh, man, this is so exciting. This is like, oh. If the camera dies again, I will kill myself. Here we go.
And cut feed.
I got 2, 3, and 8, so 13. I'm going to throw... How many demon dice can I use at a time?
Three.
I'm going to throw 3 demon dice on this.
Yeah.
Not good.
There we go.
This will go well. It doesn't roll once.
I rolled 2 ones and a 2.
So what's your total score there?
That'll be... 13 plus 4,
17. 17.
No.
Right. So, here's the sequence of events.
Oh, Jesus. We all die.
Leah takes to the sky.
I do.
No one notices her. She slips through and is overhead. The big guy... Inexplicably, the naked monster with Nazi patches sewn to his arms just strolls past the Fuhrer. The clown puppet disappears in a puff of brimstone, reappears in the cave mouth. And then one of the Nazis notices...
Oh, wait, Jimmy.
Yes.
Sorry, that's 19, because I get +2 when I try to kill Hitler.
That's cute. Okay. As Keen tries to slip past the podium, his head falls off. And it tumbles to the stage. Meanwhile, what's your name? Peltzer leaps into the air in midair with a knife overhead, and just as the head falls off, and someone yells, "Assassin!" And you freeze in midair. And the rest of you realize you're kind of moving slowly. Everyone else is frozen except for a group of Nazis standing up next to Hitler.
Oh, shit.
One of them grabs him and disappears. And the other two pull out advanced, like ray gun looking weapons, laser lugers. You just pissed off the Corona Nazis by attempting to assassinate Hitler.
Oh, yeah.
These are time-traveling white supremacists who exist to keep time travelers from going back in time and killing Hitler.
Yeah!
And so you are now trapped in a bubble of slow time, and it's their turn. So, first of all, the main Nazi puts up a shield and repels your attack directly into you, doing 19 points of damage.
Oh, jeez!
So, defend against your own attack.
Okay.
Oh.
So I worked on my other stunt here a little bit.
Oh, also,
I don't know if this applies.
Demon dies from this.
Shit. You know what? Here, guys, I just want to explain myself. Like, I know this is a game, but it's also a show. I think it's a show first. And I do these things for the viewer, not for you guys. I just want you to know. There was no camera on me. I'd consider your feelings a little bit.
But, I knew I could count on you to attack him.
but I got stumped. So my other stunt here, smaller than a womp rat, I gain +2 to quickly defend against targeted attacks.
Seems pretty good.
Or things that are, okay, I mean, but does that work though, since it's my own attack that's being directed back at me? Like, can I say, oh, I'm too small to hit myself? Oh.
It's being directed directly at you.
Okay, so +2 to that. I will try to... I can't really sneak out of this since they're looking right at me. I'll try to be quick about it. Move out of the way quickly. Try to move faster than I'm allowed to move right now. That's a D8 quick. And then maybe... I don't know, what discipline do you suggest I use for this? Like, what makes the most sense?
I mean, combat, covert... not really. Your fringe would probably be fine.
Yeah.
I would probably... In fact, in all things combat, like, when in doubt, use fringe.
Okay. Part of my fringiness is my ability to just show up and move around wherever I want, so perfect. Okay, that's a D10 plus a D8. And you said I can take 3 demon dice at a time?
At a time.
For one roll, you can roll them one at a time.
You got any faith dice left?
I have some faith dice left. Let's see here. I used 2 of them. I have 1 left.
Demon dice are what got you here in the first place.
Oh, but the audience loved it. I'm going to hide in the coffee mug again. Why not? Okay, another D6. All right, this time 6, 6, 5. Ooh, not bad. So 17, plus 2.
18, 19. Awesome. Yeah. So you, what's this look like?
So I'm like, I'm sitting there, I'm like, ah, and then like the attack starts coming, and I'm like, and then I dodge it.
All right. Sounds good.
I was expecting something way flashier.
Right. No, I'm not. I'm trying to separate my characters a little bit. I'm not bullock.
So, let's see. Let's say there's... We got three chrononazis you're up against here. So, second one is going to spin around, take aim at the people who have snuck into the cave mouth, and just kind of lay down a spread. So that would be everyone but Peltzer and Leah. No one has noticed Leah up above.
Nice.
The fucking jokes up there.
Exactly.
Okay.
Nazis, general skinheadery. Firing at you with their laser lugers. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. 8 exactly.
All right.
Oh, shit. No. I am not going to get my +2 because these are chrononazis and they have seen supernatural things before. So I'm going to take a mild condition.
Ooh.
Flesh wound.
I got 15.
Yeah, you did. So, we are bringing back where the fuck did... And you disappear into a puff of evil.
Wow. Yeah.
And John, give me a roll.
Okay. Looking around for a physical sheet. I have it right here. I'm going to go with the... careful combat, since I am slowed super down, and I've never had this happen to me before. Oh, I have a 5, but I have a 1.
On just your normal dice?
Yes, on normal dice.
Okay, so you can choose to reroll that, correct?
Yes. Correct. What does that cost?
It gives him a demon die.
Or, I'm a monster. Let's go ahead. What?
Or the other thing you could do is take the score, gain a faith die for rolling 1. If you gain a faith die, he gains a demon die.
I can't go above the faith die I already have, can I?
Yeah,
you can.
Oh, absolutely. Okay. I'm just gonna reroll it. That's much better. That's a 13.
Alright.
So, the shot goes straight over your lack of head.
Fantastic.
If you had a head, it would have been deadly.
Alright, and one more. Takes a follow-up shot at the assassin. So, gonna use up one of those guys. Actually, we'll take 2 of them because he is an active threat. Was it 8 plus 10 plus... So we've got Hitler's time-traveling bodyguards and armed with future tech laser lugers. Whoops. Okay. 10 plus 15. 25.
Whoa.
Good luck, Ben.
Wow.
I'm going to need a minute.
Okay, you do have, yes, we are Nazis, as...
Yeah, that's sitting out there.
You could
they might be momentarily
that.
Thrown.
Like, wait,
this
he
is kind
a
of
Nazi, awesome. Though. Was he really going after Hitler, or did we make
he just yells, wait, I'm one of you.
Wait. So what's the context of that one? I think I missed that.
Oh, Don... tore all of the Nazi insignias off a guy's uniform and sewed them onto all of your arms.
Except
oh,
for
okay.
Him.
Yeah, I will use that then.
I no longer have a Nazi head.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to cash in. I'm going to say, hey, I'm with that guy. Look, we're on your side. Look at that shit. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to try to be quick about it again, right? Still quick about it. This fucking D8 keeps disappearing. Where did the D8 go? And then covert again. Yeah, that'll be it. Okay, 6 dice. Here we go. I got 5, 7, 1. So 13.
That sucks.
Yeah, sucks a lot. That's with all your demon dice, or?
I haven't rolled any demon dice yet.
You might want to roll some demon dice.
Stacks them on here. Start with this one. Shit. It's spinning right now. It's spinning. Holy shit, it's spinning. And it's a 2. Fucking A. Here's another one. And this one's a goddamn 1.
Oh, 1 on a demon die.
Should I just do everyone a favor and kill myself? Okay, let me take a moment here and look at my numbers. I got 7 and 5, and there's 13, 15, 16 with a 1 on a demon die. Fuck it, 1 more demon die. Let's see what happens. And it's a 4. Okay, so it's at...
It's at 20, so that would be that would be a mild condition you'd be taking. 20.
Oh, plus 2 to defend against a targeted attack.
Still mild.
2. Yeah, that's all I got. All
right.
Give you 3 more goddamn demon dice. Okay, so what's my mild condition going to be?
All right, you are, let's call it laser singed. And, oh boy, what to do to you? crap, I got nothing. Let's see.
An easy way would be that he takes an extra mild condition.
Yeah, let's just do that. So you are also let's just say you're frozen in space on this one.
Wasn't he already frozen in space?
Everyone's just kind of slow time. This one actually locked him into place. So he's pretty much screwed if they try to get him again. But it's not their turn.
And at least it's not fucking corn dogs.
Yes. Right. So since no one has noticed her, I think it is Leah's turn. Leah. Let's go with Leah.
But I'm still moving really slow, right?
You are not affected. No one knows you're there.
Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. All right. I'm going to sing at one of the Chrono Nazis to try to get him to shoot one of the other Chrono Nazis.
All right.
Because why not?
That's right? A great plan, as far as I'm concerned.
I like it. Exciting. Would you say that this is an obstacle I'm trying to overcome?
Sure.
Great. I'm going to add some stuff to it. And I am trying to rain death from above, so can I also invoke that?
What is it? Is it an aspect or a stunt?
It is an aspect.
Are they both aspects? Or?
No. The stunt is... because I love being the center of attention. Yeah. With a plus 2.
You can invoke as many aspects as you got dice for.
Great. I'm going to invoke everything.
Oh, yeah.
Invoking it all. Let's see what we got here. Okay. All right. Hold on. 10. 16.
18. 18. Wow. 18. Okay. So, not only do you get him to shoot his buddy,
yeah.
The shot goes wild, it goes through him, vaporizes the guy, goes through him, hits just a random Nazi out in the crowd, and his buddy next to him is paradoxed out of existence because that was a ancestor.
Yeah, bonus Nazi.
Nice.
Because they are, as you have just learned, paradox prone. And the guy that you shot first was the one controlling the slow time. So everyone is back to normal motion.
Yay!
That was which means great. Honeycutt Peltzer slams into the ground face first.
Oh. Poor guy.
It's okay. I look cool doing it.
You do. do I need to go next?
There is one Nazi left. One Chrono Nazi left.
One Chrono Nazi left? But I feel like Headless hasn't gone yet.
Well, most of us haven't gone yet.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm going to let Headless go.
Yeah.
With the Nazi with him.
Good idea. John.
Yes. Okay. I'm really, really mad that they used slow time on me, because it's being slowed is something I've never experienced as a doula hand. So I am going to whip him good. As good as I can. And I'm going to try and whip that gun out of his hands.
Right.
Indiana Jones style. So, that's D10 and a D10 for quick, because I do not want to be slowed again. I get plus one. Wait, that's a six. I know what dice are. Usually. That is a 14 plus 1, so 15.
Woo!
All right.
Yeah.
He is going to attempt to jump forward in time to when your whip no longer exists. It is no longer in that spot. Just pop it back. And so let's see. That's probably all I can use. That's not good. 3, 4, 5. So, yeah. You whipped him good. And he goes down for the count.
Nice.
So, the time bubble that was freezing everyone in place still seems to be in place for the time being, but you notice they're starting to move a little bit, so it might be a good idea to clear out before all of the Nazis notice you.
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We head down the cave.
All right.
I'm going to take his gun before we go, though.
Yeah.
I'll give it to the gremlin.
Where the fuck is the clown?
Can I see
the clown?
Yeah, here you go. I have not seen the clown.
The clown poofs into existence right over your shoulder.
I like it, sir.
Is it playtime?
No, creepy.
So, you enter the mines and find yourself confronted with a maze of twisting passages all alike. Very dimly lit, and frankly, you have no idea which direction you're going. But you hear a over here.
I'll look for the source of the whisper.
That's not suspicious at all.
I think we found a friend.
You look around and find nothing. There is a featureless rock wall, and you hear it again. Psst, hey, right here.
Is this like the little worm thing from the labyrinth? He's going to ask us to come inside for a cup of tea.
I'm going to gently poke the wall with the handle of my whip.
I have created life from the dead, but life now exists without a body.
The rock wall does not appreciate being jabbed in the guts, and Felsbrecher steps forward. He was completely camouflaged, meaning he is a kobold, and he is your brotherhood informant.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hi.
stay there.
Brilliant!
So
we were sent to break things.
Yeah, you look the type. So
we want to play with Vril.
I wouldn't recommend it. The stuff is nasty. Come on, follow me. And he leads you through a twisting maze that you will probably never remember the way back.
Great.
And you emerge into a cavern, kind of dimly lit, and see that there's two massive drilling rigs positioned in the center of the cavern, and around it, just digging up normal coal, because it was formerly a coal mine, are just Nazi slave labor. And so they're digging away at the rocks, but you see the massive Vril drills are just pumping out this steady stream of bright electric yellow liquid that go up through pipes, these transparent pipes, up through the ceiling into some other part of the facility.
Wait, how do you spell that? Bright electric yellow liquid? Is that an acronym?
No, it is not.
How do you spell yours?
Vril, V-R-I-L.
Oh, V-R. Okay, I thought it was Brill this whole time. I'm an idiot. Okay. I thought I caught a witticism there, and it turns out I'm just fucking dumb. so first of all, Peltzer, he joins the rest of the party. He says, "Hey assholes, you know my legs are like an inch long, right? What's going on?"
Sorry.
I point.
Oh shit! That's some bright ass electric yellow liquid there. It's like the ground is peeing up.
So we're supposed to destroy all this, right?
Yeah.
That's what they tell me. I got any ideas? Because this stuff is dangerous as hell.
I've got a great idea.
Are you going to throw a tank at it? Oh, God.
I grab Peltzer.
Mm-hmm.
And I chuck you at the drill.
Oh, I love it. Let's do this.
Do I need to roll for that or anything, or can I just chuck him at one of the drills?
Well, let's say you threw him. I forgot my guy's name. Felsbrecher just looks at you and shakes his head and says, "Well, that's going to piss off the Steiger." The Steiger. And as Peltzer is soaring through the air, a massive black tendril comes darting out of the shadows, wraps him up, and yanks him back. And you hear just an ungodly noise of just thrashing and beating. And his body gets whipped down to the ground at your feet.
Uh-oh.
Whoops.
But let's say that he landed on the clown, so it was at least a soft landing. He's still with us. But
let's play dogpile.
He's horrified beyond reason. That's your condition, incidentally.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like I've made some mistakes tonight.
What the hell is that? I asked the kobold.
Yeah, that's the Steiger. He's kind of the foreman. He's a...
He's a black-only tendril?
I'm guessing he's a demon-possessed person.
I point out it felt more like 40 men.
I've never really got a good look at him. He doesn't tend to come out of the shadows.
Hmm.
But I have had the common sense not to run into the lights.
So we need to put the lights out?
Yeah, I'm on it.
Are you sure that's a good idea? You're looking.
I don't know what good ideas are anymore.
Oh. I know my way around electricity, so I try and find like a power panel or something. And I see if I can reroute the electricity with my bare hands.
Okay.
Since I'm going maybe into the ground. I don't know. But the whole idea is that I want to shut the lights off. And I don't know if I'm going to find, you know, a breaker box or anything. So I want to use my Frankenstein knowledge of electricity to, you know, cut the power.
Okay.
And I shall do this forcefully. And I have no... Damn it. But I am... Okay, so that is a 14.
All right. You rip the cables out of the wall, jam them into the ground, manage to not electrocute yourself to second death in the process, and plunge the room into darkness. So now the creature that could only travel in the shadows has access to the entire room.
Okay.
But I was fucked up.
Was, so I have created an advantage, basically, right now.
If you want to call it that.
That was the intent of the action here. This is not an overcome. It was a creative advantage. Anyway, I realize it's going to be used against us. That's fine. So the question is, so there should be a D6. We can call it, like, it's dark, whatever. Blackout.
It's dark, whatever.
We'll call it bright idea.
Yes. The irony. Yeah, and I'm assuming I did not succeed with style.
No.
Okay, great. Good to know. And that is what I do.
All right.
Not help this. I have not helped this at all.
Way to win.
So yeah, in response, the Steiger reaches down and yanks you up to the ceiling, slams you up against the rock, and back to the ground again. Or at least that's its goal.
Okay.
So let's get some grappling, some wall crawling foreman of the Wenceslas Mines, and creepy ass long arms. And this is decidedly forceful. I got a 12.
Okay. Doesn't look good, but I'm going to try it. That is a 9. Not bad.
Demon dies.
I know.
That's so many. He's just going to use them all.
I'm going to go ahead and take it.
All right.
At least this game's the one-off, right?
Yeah.
That's how we all died.
What do we call this? Pounded or something?
Oh, you're taking the hit.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, sure. All right, let's see what the clown has to offer. Have at it, Andy. You are muted. We can't hear you. You're trapped in the demonic nether spaces.
Unmute yourself, bro.
Ah, there we go. I get to play now. So the Shagger has been, grabbing people and throwing them, and Because I'm just an innocent little toy, once per session, I am suddenly where you least expect me.
Alright.
Which is in his shadow. Nice. And I'm going to try to eat his tentacled eyeballs.
Ew.
Excellent. They're an easy target, because he has these massive overdeveloped eyes for seeing in the dark.
Yeah! Leftovers! All right. And I'm going to evoke, let's see, what a cute toy that will eat your soul. And let's see here. Because people are inexplicably afraid of clowns, I get a +2 to cleverly kill them when they least expect it.
All right. You can only use one stunt at a time.
Okay. Well, oh, yeah. All right. Sounds good. Then...
But I'm going to call this an overcome because he has no idea you just appeared there.
Excellent. All right.
Very excellent.
That's
you
a 19.
Overcame, and homeboy is blind.
Yeah!
And you have leftover eyeball.
Yummy!
And, wow. Yeah, so he has a... He is blind. Let's call that a severe condition.
Cool.
Seems pretty severe.
So, yeah, he has no idea where you are. So who's up next?
All right. I think it's... I think it's time for some heads to roll. I think the Headless Wonder is next.
Yes. Fantastic. See what I can do to this. How big is this thing? It's pretty sizable, right?
It's technically man-sized, but the arms and legs seem to grow without limit.
Okay. Okay.
Got kind of an insectile wall crawling thing going on.
All right. I'm pretty much a one-trick pony if I'm not chasing somebody down. So I'm gonna whip him good while he's distracted.
Bum, 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 bum.
That is an 8 and a 9, and I can use faith dice if I'm not invoking a discipline, right? Like for a bonus?
So you use faith dice to invoke your aspects.
Okay. Yeah, none of these really work. All right, so I have an 8.
Okay. He is freaking out all over the place. For everything he does is going to be forceful. And let's toss some grappling in there, because he's just slapping around blindly, hoping to hit you with his creepy-ass long arms. 16 plus 5, 21.
Yeah, he just slaps that right away.
Yeah.
Okay. An attempt was made.
So, who's up next?
I think next is going to be Leah.
So, can I invoke my aspects? Do you know who my daddy is? Because my daddy's a god. So,
okay.
Maybe I could hurt him with, like, radiant light. Like, I know he's blind now, but, like, hurt him with, like, radiant god force.
That's worth a shot.
All right.
For the record, radiant god force is my favorite anime.
imagine that would probably be fairly flashy and probably alright, give this a go. Oh yeah. 24.
Okay.
Damn.
So you're hitting him with a blinding holy light?
I am.
All right. Well, those are two of his weaknesses.
Yeah.
So he is burnt to a friggin' crisp.
Nice.
So all that's left is a dirty white suit that flops down to the floor of the now slightly glowing mine from your holy radiance.
Thank you.
All right. Well done.
So Der Steiger is done, and woo, the slave laborers job. Who are toiling away have run around to thank you for slaying their captor.
You're welcome.
We start eating them.
Yeah, I'm a little hungry. Channeling the power of a god. It's really super tiring.
That so, looks fun.
I run up and try and get a really good look of this Vril scheme, what they're doing with it, and how it's coming out of the ground and that sort of thing.
Okay.
I'm gonna make this like a knowledge advantage that I'm trying to get using my brilliant sciencey mind. So this would be a clever research and development. That is a 16.
All right. So it was you discovered that. I mean, not much to tell here. This is a pretty standard mining drill, except for the length of it, which seems to go very far into the earth.
Okay.
And but you have succeeded in style, so you get to create ooh, an advantage.
Improvisational assistant, because Igor is the real brains here. Whenever I succeed with style, when I overcome or create an advantage using mad science, Igor adds an additional 3 invoke.
Excellent. So what are we calling this guy?
Vril, I don't know. Know the void, I don't know. Knowledge of the...
Let's call it well, Vril. What you got? You yelled something.
I was thinking like well of knowledge or well no that's not working. Vril, I'm Vril.
I got.
Figure it out. Okay.
And that's 2d6s on there.
3 of them. We get 3
awesome.
Dice.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
All right. So we're trying to take this operation out, right?
That's
yes.
Our goal is to fuck all this up. Okay. So am I allowed to take as many invokes as I want when I do something?
What does that mean?
Like if I see the Vril smarts there, D6, D6, D6.
Oh yeah, you can take anything.
I can just take them all.
Yeah.
Okay, so I just kind of walk, like I've had a bad day, right? And if there's one thing we're known for, it's being mischievous and playful, and I've had enough of that. So I walk up, I'm still holding the laser gun that I was handed earlier, and I'm like, okay, I gotta do this, I gotta sabotage this shit. And I see some moving parts, and I just fucking jam the gun into moving parts and run.
Oh, God. Oh. That's one way to use it.
Yep. So I'm going to use all those D6s. I'm going to use Clever, because I thought that was funny. And my friend, Gremlin Power. And let's see what I get. All right. That's 6 plus 3 is 9, plus 4 is 13, 7 is... 20, and 8 is 28.
Woo! Well done.
Yeah.
So, that is a very much a success with style. So, you have managed not only to jam up the one that you were doing, but it kind of swells up along the base and the seams in it rip, and it spews a stream of Vril out onto the other one and melts the side of it. And so you've managed to take out both drills at the same time.
Nice.
Nice.
Good job.
You've Vrilled the drills. Really hard to say.
It has, however, created a whole lot of noise, and in through the cave entrance you came in through come a pair of mecha-soldaten, Nazi soldiers in huge armored mech suits.
Oh, yeah.
And they... screen share. Hide the secret stuff.
Gremlin against the machine. This happened.
And so you have just pissed off these guys.
Oh,
they are coming for you. But at the moment, they are distracted by the exploding Vril drills. So you have the advantage. So who wants to go first?
I jump on his back.
All right, and?
I'm going to gremlin the shit out of him. Well, I mean, I got sneaky, right? Because he's got, like, mech parts, right? He's got robot armor, so...
Oh, yeah, this is a mech soldier.
First thing I got to do is be sneaky and fringy and get, like, on him without being noticed, right?
Sure.
So that'll be 15.
You're on him.
Cool. And is that all I can do, or can I start poking with him?
That's all you can do for now.
Okay, so I'm on him.
So you're just riding a soldier.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Who has gone well? How about the puppet? I think the puppet hasn't done much other than sneak around and be weird and make me uncomfortable.
Well, it looks like the gremlin's got one.
Oh, guy ball thing too. Yeah, that little thing.
Look, we've got friends to play with. Hey, let's play hide and go seek. Maybe you can find me. Or maybe I can find you.
Never sleeping again.
Yeah, I'm going to go for covert ops and. You know what? I feel like this is a clever possessed toy thing. I'm gonna evoke. I'm just a puppet who can see the strings, and attempt to sabotage their suits.
All right.
Maybe go for the one that doesn't have a gremlin on it already.
Good call.
Whoop. I have too many dice there. The purple one wasn't supposed to be there.
All right.
Which is really convenient since it's the least number.
Well, you did good. So you have discovered that they have very poorly grounded electronics.
Excellent.
So, so by doing that, you have shocked the crap out of one of them and inflicted a moderate, let's call it,
This is fun. Let's play every day. All right, Leah, what do you got?
Well, I could I could sing to them. That's what I'm good at. Try to get them to. I could sing to one. Maybe the one that's already been weakened with the shock, to try to get him to attack the other one. And I got an 11 for that.
All right. I'm going to try to defend against it.
Damage resistance. Oh, that's his condition. Right? That's not like an invoke thing.
I missed what?
The condition. That's a condition?
Yeah, you can't invoke that without... Okay. Can you target it somehow if you charge it, like create an advantage on it?
You can. It works just like any other aspect. So yeah. If I have a faith die, I can invoke that.
Okay. Oh, well, there you go. So it's an aspect, so you do know about it.
Okay. That's okay.
Okay. So I'm going to forcefully attempt to resist the damage and using the acoustics built into my Vril-powered mech suit. So, 11. What did you have?
I had an 11.
Hey, awesome. So you did nothing to me.
Did. I'm tired. I was just channeling a god. Sorry, guys.
So who's next?
I would like the patchwork wonder. So.
Brilliant.
That it, Roderick.
All right. Are these cables still live?
Sure.
Okay.
You got your bright idea still up there, so.
I do. I don't see it in here, but okay. Leftover eyeballs. I don't think I can use that.
Those are for you. That is a snack for later.
And in fact, if I could, I wouldn't. okay. I am going to...
Oh, you should have your bright idea on there.
Right. Okay. And do I have any dice on that? Yeah, okay,
yeah,
great.
1d6. Awesome.
I'm going to use that. I'm going to cleverly... because now we know of their weakness, I'm going to cleverly research and development. I'm going to Frankenstein this thing. Try and I'm not going to just bash him with the cord. I want to see if I can really just jam it in the right spot. So that's those two, and I will take the bright idea die. And you know what? I'm getting overzealous here. That's good enough. You're down to 6 demon dice. Yeah, I'll go ahead and take one. I'm going to reroll this approach.
All right.
Worth it. That's an 8. I got an 18 total.
I did not. I got a 5. So, one of them is a crispy critter.
Okay.
Which one?
Yeah. Let's call it the clown one.
Yeah. I was definitely going for that one too.
All right. Let's say he. He was the one who already had taken damage. So, yeah, that is severe.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's got some milds left, but he is hurting.
Okay. And I guess it's them, right? Or John hasn't gone yet.
That's right, I haven't gone.
But if you go, then they go twice.
No, there's only one of them left.
Oh, that's right. But if he go, then he gets...
Oh, there's two. There's still two.
Oh, there's two. Oh, yeah, there's two. Okay. I don't know. Let's have them go.
All right. So, we'll start with the one who is on his last legs. He whips out a Vril hand grenade. Pulls the pin, shucks it at the ground.
That's right.
And takes himself out in the process. However, everyone in the splash radius, which is everyone is going to take 2d10 damage. So go ahead and roll that for me.
Would we all roll our own?
We're rolling our own damage.
Let's call it 1d10.
Okay. I have
Yeah, you're all spread out a bit, so some of you might take more than others.
Okay. That's just automatic? We don't defend against that?
No, this is an explosion.
Yeah, okay. Ouchies.
In fact, my guy has to also because he wasn't ready for that. Oh.
Well, we're going to call that...
I call shenanigans, Jimmy.
Let's do this. One. It's 10 damage. You can subtract anything you roll.
Oh.
Oh.
That's okay. Better.
Yeah.
So 2 damage.
That's a 4.
Wait. I liked the other way better.
So because ragdolls are used to getting thrown around, I can choose to be tossed away to shrug off a mild condition when I cleverly defend against physical attacks. So I don't get to defend. Can I still use the stunt? Feels like getting blown to the wall of the room, it would be appropriate.
True.
Is that a once per session thing, or?
No.
It's up to Jimmy.
Yeah, have at it.
All right.
So you go flying deep into the caverns of the mine. No one quite saw where you were headed.
Hey, guys!
So, okay, my
so
guy...
Those of us... Oh, sorry. So those of us who did take damage, what is the condition for this called?
Blowed up.
Blowed up.
Yeah, I took singed and I recharged my glow in the dark.
Awesome.
Nice.
Yeah, it was a Vril bomb, so... All right, so I only got one guy left standing, and he is not feeling very well. But he's feeling well enough to whip around and fire his dual-wielded chainsaws on everyone he can see, which would be... we got Froderick, Leah, and Keen are all going to have to defend.
Okay.
Against... All right. Dual-wielded chainsaws.
Presuming that he's seen supernatural things before.
Oh, my, yes.
Yeah. Damn it.
I'm going to attempt to dodge quickly away from the chainsaws. I have a 9. Great. The same.
I have an 8.
You are all up against an 11.
Sure, I'll demon dice.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and...
Now I have a 13 with a demon die.
With the demon die, I have an 11 exactly.
Excellent, I got my demon dice back. Don, how you doing?
Where are you sitting?
11.
11. Yeah, you can have a demon die.
All right.
And I'm at a 15.
Cool. So, yeah, all of you, how did you manage to avoid the onslaught from 2 chain guns aimed in your direction from point-blank range?
I go for the ground.
I have a giant hole in my body already, and it just shot right through it.
Awesome.
And I took to the air.
Awesome. Well done. Okay, let's get it to Froderick.
Okay. Froderick smash. And so I'm going to forcefully smash at him. And I'm going to try and toss him into the spraying Vril.
All right.
I Why not? Yeah, 13.
Is that a demon die?
Nope.
Okay. It's fine.
Damn it.
14.
Oh, man.
So, you whiffed it.
Lame. Leia.
So this is a morbid use, but he just shot at me, so I'm going to sing at him so that he will shoot himself.
All right.
Because F that guy. And I got a 13.
All right, let's see what I got.
Less than 13.
11.
Yay!
So, dog just scared the crap out of me.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he shoots himself, but it's a grazing shot. So he's, let's call it moderate. He's moderately injured with a bad case of head bullet.
Yeah.
Oh, it's yeah. So, who's next?
Okay, Gremlin.
Okay. So, where am I in relation to everything?
You are riding this guy's back.
Still on him.
So that guy didn't explode or anything. I want to make sure that nothing changed since I looked away for a minute.
Except now you have knowledge that he has poorly grounded electronics.
Okay. I want to rig his gun to explode on the next trigger pull.
Cool.
All right, so I'm going to go sneaky fringe. And that is 16.
Nice. You did it. So, just a success. But next time he pulls that trigger, he is going to blow up. Who's next?
Let's see here.
You could make him go.
Yeah.
It seems like the obvious choice. Sure.
All right.
Oh, I jump off him, by the way.
Good call. I am pretty mad at this woman who just tried to sing me to death, so I'm going to turn my guns on her. Full force. Ten. Is that 25?
Mm-hmm.
So, while they do blow up, you're still going to have to defend against that.
Whoa. That seems like a bad thing. All right. Well. All right. Well, I'll give you a couple of demon die. How about? Oh boy. Okay, well, with 3 demon die, well, there we go. All right, well, with 3 demon die, I got a 22. All
right, so...
I can't take any more demon die, so...
Well, yeah, you're going to take a mild condition as the shrapnel from my exploding corpse flies past you and you get a couple nicks and scratches.
All right, shrapnel!
Exactly.
Okay.
So,
great, so we fixed everything, right? Now we just gotta get out.
Well, Bellsbracket says you could get out, but, I mean, you still got all the Vril left upstairs.
What do we have to do with the Vril?
Well,
let's play with it.
It seems highly flammable.
It does.
It looks fun.
Why don't we let the clown...
How do we get upstairs?
He leads you over to a minecart elevator, and you guys get hoisted up, and you find yourselves in a kind of a catwalk area overlooking a room filled with vats of Vril. We're talking multiple, probably 200,000-gallon vats of Vril up here. Whatever the Fuel Society is doing, it is way bigger scale than a couple of magic tanks out on the battlefield. And the floor down below is patrolled by the guy outside had his count way wrong. There are legions of Nazis and Fuel Wizards patrolling down there. You see a couple of the tanks rolling around. You see some mechanical dogs running back and forth alongside more of those mech soldiers. There's a goddamn army down there. And you notice that all of the Vril that is being pumped into these tanks, there's even more that is being drawn further upwards into another part of the facility.
Whoa.
Anybody got a match?
I think it's probably beyond that. But we're clearly not getting anywhere near those vats. I asked the kobold, what's upstairs?
He says, and I try not to go outside very much, but I know they've been doing some construction up there. They took a whole bunch of big-ass rocks out of my stash. I picked out some choice ones. They were just for me, this beautiful marble, and they stole them.
How many, is everybody, like, does everybody have a lot of conditions right now?
I just have one.
I wonder how many of mine are still relevant.
You're no longer horrified. Okay. Let's say you're definitely not frozen in place. You're still kind of blowed up in laser singe, though. So you'll have to actually do something to recover from those.
Probably should have patched those up before we walked into the cave.
Exactly.
Y'all got some long legs, and I couldn't do it alone. actually, character confession time. Right now, like, my trouble aspect is called can't not fuck with shit. Yeah. And I am just shaking with all the tech in this room.
So, and, this is going to really learn a lot if we were to volunteer for their experiments, right? We could see what they were doing, and then we could, once we're in, we could use it against them.
You could just throw me in the vat.
Done.
Leia takes off. No.
So okay. Seriously though, should I have to roll to endure my trouble aspect, or?
I think you just start fucking shit up, man.
Okay, I'm gone.
That was what we were sent here for. Fuck shit up. So.
But me going rogue is. So many good things have happened when I go rogue.
It's true.
Yeah, I'm gone. You don't know where I went.
Great.
I jump into the crowd. I start crossing wires. I'm having the time of my life.
Yeah.
My life has led to this moment. This is why I was put here.
So, Peltzer is now an enemy. He is jeopardizing the mission and likely to get every one of you killed.
We all know we're not making it out of this alive.
Oh, I still want to.
Okay.
I mean, some of us aren't even alive to begin with. I'm not.
You make an interesting point.
I may or may not be.
I'm uncomfortable enough with you that I may just chuck you in a vat.
Let's plan.
I need to use my brilliant scientist mind to figure out what the hell is going on here and what they're actually doing. So I can see clearly that they're collecting it, they're powering weapons and stuff. But with the wizards and everything else, that's thrown me. I'm wondering if, like, I can put some of this together and create an advantage of some kind of sure. master. You know, I understand the plan. Kind of thing.
Okay. Give me something.
Okay. So, clever research and development. It's a 15.
So what?
15.
All right. So, you don't know the magic side of things so well.
Yeah.
So, but you definitely recognize that this sheer volume of dessert topping is insane. No one has ever harnessed the power of this much power before. And so, whatever they're doing upstairs is unprecedented in human existence.
Do and I think that
sort of thing you'd probably like to get your eyes on?
Yeah, okay. I'm like, you know what, guys? I don't want to see the storage shed. I want to see the laboratory. You know what I mean?
I suppose so.
No.
We're going upstairs. I have to go upstairs.
Whoa.
Okay.
And I asked the kobold, how do I get upstairs?
The elevator keeps going up. We just stopped here so you could see all the Vril.
Oh, awesome.
And we could lose shelter, apparently.
Yeah, I wouldn't leave that guy poking around down there, because, I mean, God knows what those doodads and gizmos down there do, but, I mean, look at the people guarding. It can't be good.
Leah may have to scoop me up before I get to the fray.
All right.
Like a hawk.
I will.
Going after a meddlesome rabbit.
Yes.
So, Peltzer's not going to like that, so you're going to have to defend against her attack.
I'll try not to eat you.
No problem.
Yeah, fight your instincts better than I could.
Right, I got a 12.
It's only a snack, anyways.
Okay, let's see here. I'm quick. I teleport around a little bit. D8. Where'd they go again? And then, because I'm smaller than a womp rat, I gain +2 to quickly defend against targeted attacks. That'll be 13 plus 2, 15.
Balls. Well, we're leaving them. Okay.
Don't want to demon dice up that roll?
No, I do not.
No. I'm just a victim of my nature, and you're going to leave me.
Oh, I love it, guys. Fine. 16.
All right.
All right. You
snag the little bastard by the crook of the scruff of his neck and haul him back up to slam him in the back of the elevator.
I'm going to shake him vigorously.
I scream, no! This is why I'm here. This is what I've longed for.
Keep him pinned to the ground the entire time so we can't break the elevator either.
He's going to hold on. Flap him around a little bit while we're going upstairs.
He's crying. You don't know. You don't know what it feels like.
So, Felsbrecher just kind of waves you off, says, look, I got no business up there. I'm heading back down, but you guys have a great night and have fun killing Nazis. And you hop in, hit the button for the top floor, and you emerge to a clearing where the Nazis have apparently built a massive monolithic structure. Boom. Looking like this. So the uprights are apparently Felsbrecher's stolen marble columns.
Aha.
Nazi concrete wrapped around it. They're all inlaid with strange runic symbols, and every one of them is wrapped in clear electric tubing that carries Vril in a circle all the way around it. You see it just whipping around faster and faster.
Man, that looks like it could fall down.
There's a in the center of the ring, there's a circumscribed pentagram, and at the center of it stands a man in a full-face helmet crafted from a stag skull, shirtless, and there's a black sun tattoo over his heart with the order sigil burned directly into the center of it.
And we can see his stats.
Everybody screen cap his stats.
Hey, no, look away! Look away!
I'm a puppet that can see the strings.
You are facing off against Der Hexenmeister. He's wielding his weird diesel-punky looking staff with a hose full of Vril coiled around it that leads to a backpack reservoir of the stuff. And he is chanting in some godforsaken tongue that sounds strangely familiar, yet it hurts your ears to hear it.
I still don't know where my actual head is, correct?
Yeah, it doesn't hurt your ears.
No.
Okay.
Wow, we should go play with the bad man.
Yeah, go get him.
Sounds like fun.
I apologize to Leo for my outburst earlier.
I look for...
I have to be released.
I look for where the Vril is coming up through the ground, and see if I can get access to mad science it up a little bit.
All right, give me a roll.
Okay. Yeah, now I'm going to give you a demon die.
Sweet.
And that is a 22.
Wow, nicely done. So you see that the Vril comes out at the base of each of these columns. It's like a big armored pipe fitting at the bottom. So there's pipes coming up to each of the columns. And around each of those are acolytes of the order. Cool. They're kind of a robed cultists with their eyes and their mouths are sewn shut. They got these nasty, wicked-looking Kree daggers in each hand. And they're not chanting, but they seem to be sort of humming along with the chanting of Der Hexenmeister.
Okay.
So... you, let's see. So, I mean, you see him, and you think, yeah, I could probably do something with him, but you have to get to him first.
Got it. But,
so, let's see. You get a... what do you want to call this?
Hear no evil.
Sure, we can do that. That's the one thing they can do. They can.
Yeah, but they can't speak. Their mouth is so shut. So I presume I did not succeed with style.
You did.
I did.
So double D6.
Triple D6.
Oh, yes, because of Mr. Igor.
Yeah, Igor jumps out and says, "Master, what about this?" Oh, yeah. And how did you get here?
A good henchman is always at the ready.
Right.
So, as you were inspecting the facilities, crack opened in the center of nothing in the middle of the structure, and began widening. There's just this hole in reality that seems to lead into a flaming hellscape.
I think this is what we're supposed to prevent.
That looks fun.
Is the guy in the center still chanting? Has he noticed us yet?
He has not.
Okay. I would like to distract him. I am going to invoke my aspect, Office Casual, to summon my steed immediately.
Awesome.
And I'm going to go run his ass down and try and get him tangled up in the whip.
Solid.
Oh, no! Okay, that is a 16 total.
Okay, so that succeeds. So you hop on the back of that horse and go dashing around him in a circle, and he has definitely noticed you, but has not stopped enchanting at all.
Yeah, okay.
In fact, he speeds up a little bit, and it widens even further, and you see this glowing yellow eye, probably the size of a Goodyear blimp, staring down at you.
Great.
Although the Goodyear blimp doesn't exist yet, so just a blimp.
Wait, when was Hindenburg?
There you go.
All right.
So, the longer you take, the bigger this hole is growing in reality.
Can I yank him down and try to knock him out? Like, is the ground stone in there, or is it just on grass?
It is, it's like a stone center.
Fantastic, I'm going to try and yank him down. And I will do this quickly, as the hole is getting bigger. I have a 10.
All right. Well, the pentagram is inlaid with gold, so I'm invoking your trouble aspect.
Okay.
And he is going to, where'd you go here? Forcefully channel some Vril in your direction. And the power of Vril throws through me. I'm a dark warlock of the order. So,
oh, God.
19 plus 19 and 9, a lot, 28?
Yeah.
So that's more than 10.
Yeah,
so you
lot.
Do nothing, and...
Instead start riding away.
The hole has widened to the diameter of these stone circles, and through it, this massive red arm comes reaching through, like, enormous, and kind of swats down on the ground, and it's like something's trying to pull itself through.
Okay, I charge the cultists.
All right.
You should throw me at the eyeball.
Yes, you should. Let the scary clown... I'll take him. Fly him up to the eyeball.
Okay, you do that. That'll be... okay. So... I am going to Frederick Smash, and that'll be that and that. Forceful.
You're attacking the acolytes?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And I'm going to go ahead and grab a D6 from the Hear No Evil, because maybe they're distracted by this big giant thing coming through. And then I'm also going to go ahead and invoke Freaked the Shit Out as I take a condition where I am genuinely frightened by this thing.
I was like, where are you seeing this one?
And I will add another D6 to my pile of... Yeah. Okay, 9 plus 6 is 15, plus another 5 is 20. Yeah, I'm going to let that ride.
All right. So, 8 and 7, 15. So, yeah, you wipe out a chunk of them. So you've done, let's say, 3 of them are knocked out.
Okay. Does that do anything to the circle?
Not so far. It's still chugging away, but you have taken out all of the ones who were guarding one of the pylons.
Okay. And I will have Leah go next.
I'm throwing the clown at the eyeball.
All right. And it's not just an eyeball anymore, it is the full head. It's crimson skin, giant horns. You are seeing the emergence of Satan himself into the world, and he is probably 500 feet tall.
Great. That's lots of eyeball for you, buddy.
Squeezing through this tiny hole, and it's not going great for him. He seems to be stuck.
Good.
That's perfect. All right. That looks like the most delicious, scrumptious eyeball I've ever seen.
God damn, that's creepy.
Yummy!
Do I have to roll for that?
You don't, but he does.
Okay. So, I'm just a cute toy that will eat your soul. And I'm gonna invoke everything. Oh yeah. So yep.
Oh shit.
So what is that? 26?
Any of those demon dice?
No.
Okey-doke.
I think we need 3 more demon dice.
All right. And since the demon dice are mine, since you have used demon dice against me, I get 2 of them per each one you use.
Okay.
So you just gave me 12 additional demon dice.
Oh, Jesus.
For 6 additions. So where are you standing?
Right. That's a 40.
All right.
Oh my god. Damn.
42? Something like that.
So, since I'm the Prince of Darkness, I can roll 10 additional dice, or 4 additional d10s, rather. So, what do I got here? 4, 8, 16, 26...
You guys are just making up rules now.
You're the one who threw a clown puppet at Satan.
I think that was perfectly justified. If Satan came to my house, I would throw a creepy clown puppet at him.
It seems totally reasonable to me.
So, I have 41.
Oh! Oh my god! Oh! I get a plus 2 to cleverly kill people while they least expect them.
Oh!
How is it worded?
Because people are inexplicably afraid of clowns, I get a plus 2 to cleverly kill them when they least expect it.
Yes, people.
Well, true. Yeah.
You're not taking down Satan because you're a clown.
So, wait a minute.
Congratulations on getting really close.
No, I'm sorry. I just added up his dice, and he has 41.
Oh, cool. So it's a draw.
Wow. So in other words, the clown is the same as Satan. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, you can't be the best every day.
There's nothing to pre-invoke, is there?
So the Hexenmeister is down there just cackling and cheering because his ritual has come to fruition, and the Dark Lord is on his way entering the Earth realm.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Attack the pylons!
I think that means the gremlin should go.
Yeah.
Okay, so we determined that this chemical stuff is flammable or volatile, right?
Making indeed.
Yep.
Do all kinds of crazy shit. So I want to pop the hoses on his overlordy backpack and try to get that shit everywhere.
All right.
So.
Are you aiming it anywhere in particular?
I just want to, you know, like, sneak up on him and pull some hoses out of his backpack.
You don't need to sneak up on him because he is just, he doesn't care about you anymore. He is well, got just, what he wants.
I'm just using that dice.
Yeah, cool.
All right, so can I use a Hear No Evil on this one, too?
Yeah.
He is not the one who can't. Well, oh, yeah. You use it because you're avoiding the cultists.
Okay. All right, so it'll be D10, D10, D6. And, you know, unlimited potential with demon dice, right?
Exactly. Well, 3D6 percent.
All right, so I've got 18 plus 5, 23.
All right. He is not who I have pulled up. There we go.
Oh, and so, then plus two, because I'm overcoming him or creating actually, some kind of advantage or something.
You're just overcoming. He's not even paying attention. So yep. Call it a 10. What did you roll?
28.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, you... no. No, sorry. I went a little stupid there. It was 18 plus 5, 23 plus 2, all 25.
Right. All right, so still... crazy good. So you have hosed down him for one thing, and just Der Hexenmeister is gone because you have hosed him down with Vril, and he is just burst into flames and disappeared. So good on ya. But you know, Satan's still there, so don't cheer too loudly. But you have hosed down the general vicinity of the center of the pentagram where he was, so you know, don't step there because there's burning ground.
So there's no other kind of like volatile reaction we could set off with it. It's already just kind of burning.
You could have, but you only just sprayed it around. You didn't tell me where you were spraying it.
I just wanted to kind of basically coat the area with the damage.
Yeah, I asked you.
Oh, that's what you meant. I thought you meant when I targeted him. Sorry, I misunderstood. My goal was to just...
I'm glad that you did.
Okay. All right. Shit. So he's dead?
Very that's dead. Cool.
Who's left to go?
I think everybody has gone around once. So it is... well, it's Satan's turn. So... he... let's see here. The Prince of Darkness is going to... he's going to attempt to forcefully squeeze his way through this damn thing. So this is going to be an overcome. His dark powers. And does a success. Not quite good enough, unfortunately, because this thing is tight as hell. But in the process, he has knocked some stones loose in the ring, which no longer matters, really. So there's chunks of stone falling all over the place that you are going to have to defend against. Every one of you.
All right.
Even me, I'm in the air.
Sure.
Can you dodge on a horse?
Absolutely. You can probably dodge better on a horse.
Fantastic.
13.
All right.
10 here.
I got a 9.
I have a 15.
15 as well.
All right. The two 15s, you get... I guess... do you get a boost if you do it well?
You can.
Defend well?
If it's a succeed with style...
yeah, so I was setting it at 10. They both got 15.
Yep, that's a boost.
All right, so give yourselves boosts. What are you calling them? You have managed to zip away your way around the falling rocks.
Rockin'.
You are rockin'.
I like that.
And Leah, you got clipped. One of your wings got clipped by a chunk of flying stone. So you take your condition.
Hey, real quick. The boost thing, what is that again?
It's so, just like an aspect. You get a d6 and a free invoke.
Okay.
It goes away after you use it, though.
It's a one-time use.
It doesn't stick around.
And it's only for you.
Right.
So, let's give it back to the doctor.
Okay. I wish I knew this magic stuff. I don't understand how do we... but I do know science. I look for more science. How do I defeat Satan with science? God. You know what? this could be really bad. First off, before I do this really crazy thing, what is there anything that I see around me? Is there any like what is the Vril around the columns doing? You know,
you see it's racing up the tubes wrapped around the columns, and then just it runs in concentric circles around the inside of at least where the stone used to be. It's pretty much up there by itself now, forming the outline of the portal. And it's just spinning around. It seems to be kind of maybe recirculating through this system constantly.
Okay. So does it seem like with energy and whatnot, does it seem like it's powering the portal?
You're a man of science. That's probably what you would imagine.
Okay. So we need to break the generator. This is probably more epic and also less awesome. I was going to give up to Satan and try and get a bunch of faith dice. And that's probably a bad idea.
In general.
And so instead, because you don't give up to the Prince of Darkness, because that never is going to end well, I am going to Froderick smash the Vril tubes. I'm just going to grab one of the rocks that fell, and I'm going to like run up and just try and break this thing that's going around.
Awesome.
Right. Forceful. Reanimate. Froderick smash. I am invoking suicidal. Taking a severe condition for 3d6. I'll grab one of the last Hear No Evils. Maybe even grabbing, I used one, and then the gremlin used one. You forgot to mark one off. So
did you use one before? I didn't notice that. Okay, so there it goes.
Only one left. And that's 3. And I can't think of a way to use Burning Ground. I'm not that smart.
Has Burning Ground reduced the structural integrity of the place?
I'm sure that it has.
Grab it, Don.
All right, I'm going to grab it. I'm going to bring this place down. I'm going to choke Satan with his own hole. I'm going to choke you with your own hole, Satan.
Wow.
Saturday night for when?
Okay. Man, 6, 6, 8. So that's 24. 29. 29 plus 7 is math.
36.
Thank you. Plus 5 is 41.
All right. Yeah. So, Satan has kind of clawed himself up about midway. There's about maybe 250 feet of him sticking up out of this portal. And you grab these rocks and just bash them into the tubes, shattering them. Vril goes pouring out directly into your face and just melts you to a skeleton.
Yeah.
The ground is crumbling as the Vril comes pouring out of the generator, and as it winds down and you see the last of it go through the loop for the last time, the portal snaps out of existence.
Nice.
Severing Satan in half at the waist. His massive bulk comes crashing down into the weakened ground of the stone circle, plummeting through the earth, crashing down into the facility below, into the Vril storage room, lands in the space, and they detonate, spilling everywhere, and the entire facility goes up in a massive fireball that lights up the night sky for miles and miles around. And, so mission accomplished.
Yeah.
Cut to 6 months later at the London headquarters of the Brotherhood. The war has taken a dramatic turn as the bulk of the Thule Society's most powerful wizards were in attendance to see the Führer speak, who incidentally was time-jumped to a much safer place and time. So you managed to not only destroy the facility and kill Satan, but
you're welcome, world.
You wiped out the bulk of the Order's most powerful wizards in the process, and really turned the tide in the war. Suddenly, everything's coming up allied, and so there's a ceremony at the London headquarters, and your buddy Cragmore, who dropped you unceremoniously out of a plane, is there in full military dress as he adheres plaques containing your names, with your names etched into them, to the Zai wall. You've all attained the rank of Zai, the most respected, most cherished members in history of the Brotherhood, the first monsters to ever achieve such a rank.
Yay!
I love playing with the Brotherhood.
This
is a great
all returns.
End.
Awesome.
Wow.
Does he give me my head back, though? Your head wasn't there.
So you didn't bring your head.
Damn it.
Now you're a bodiless
horse. I'm so sure he took it.
I can't believe we severed Satan.
Right. Excellent.
Hey,
I mean, actually, what took over pretty much right away, but, you know, that's politics.
I think the double hand and I, we should team up, and I should ride around in the neck hole and do, like, Master Blaster. That'd be
you
awesome.
You could fit.
I love it.
All right, everyone.
Thanks, Jimmy. That was awesome.
Yeah, thanks. That was a really cool game.
Oh, it went better than I thought it would.
Definitely more deadly than any of the sessions I've ever run, so well done.
Everyone died, as opposed to no one.
That's right. All right.
We looked
well,
cool doing it, though. We looked cool dying.
Yeah, we did. We went out big time.
Yeah. Sweet. What?
All right, well, we'll reconvene in a month, and we'll see you then.
All right.
So, point of order.
Yeah.
The first Monday in July is the 4th.
Yeah, well, we'll do that.
So, probably not then.
Yeah, I don't mind doing the 4th. I have the day off. But if other people have plans,
I'd rather not.
I have plans on the 4th. I want to be out of town.
Word.
I'll be actively okay. moving. So, yeah. In the meantime, if you want to have this fun at home, go pick up a copy of this bad boy. Because, wow, is it fun.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I do some of that stuff.
I just want to point out how ridiculous it was that we were able to kill Satan, but could not kill Hitler.
But not Hitler.
Yeah. Yeah. It is easier to kill Satan than Hitler.
That's the runner of the prize.
That's tough. Yeah. Yeah, demonhuntersrpg.com. Everything you need to know, and it is a ridiculously fun game. I guess while we're closing out, maybe we could kind of talk a little bit about what's left. The player's guide is in the process of being finished somewhat. I think Cam's got a bit that he's working on writing about how to write aspects, and we're going to focus on that a little bit more because they're not easy, even to people who have been gaming for a while. And then we're going to do a short little supplement of adventure ideas. Maybe this one will be included, because that was hella fun. And then, right now, you can go to Kickstarter.com and just plug in Attacking the Darkness. Zombie Orpheus Entertainment is running a Kickstarter right now to finish this hilarious, hilarious film
so
called
Attacking the Darkness.
Oh my god. And we are being commissioned by Zombie Orpheus to make a Demon Hunter adventure using our new game where you get to play members of Jupiter Ridge, this crazy
mega church,
to stop the forces of RPGs from ruining the world. And so we are going to take our own Crawling Chaos RPG and pit them against these churchy people from Jupiter Ridge and see what happens. It'll be a lot of fun.
Nice.
So, yeah, support us on Kickstarter, and we'll see you in a month.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye, guys.
Bye.